Hi, Nikki here from Happy Hormones for Life, and today I am talking about testosterone. Now, you may think that is a hormone for men, and it is a steroid hormone mainly associated with male characteristics such as facial hair, deep voice, sperm production, libido, and muscle mass and strength. But it plays a crucial role for women too, including bone health, brain health, as well as our own sex drive and energy. Now, we only make about 5% of the levels men make, but it's a hormone that we definitely need. And just like estrogen and progesterone, testosterone levels decline during and post menopause, and this can result in a variety of health issues and symptoms if not addressed. So what are these symptoms of low testosterone? We're looking at, of course, reduced libido. I mean, some of these symptoms can also cross over with other things. They're not just for low testosterone, but these are sort of some of the things that you could be looking out for if you've already addressed other hormone imbalances. So low libido, decrease in sexual desire, arousal, changes in orgasm and overall sexual function. And then fatigue. So testosterone is very has a vital role in energy production, so motivation and positive mood as well. So when you're low in testosterone, you can feel pretty tired, lethargic, and you might have mood swings as well, because testosterone is vital for your brain function. It can increase anxiety and even depression as well if you haven't got enough of it. Next is sleep. Low testosterone has been associated with poor sleep quality or insomnia. Again, other things can impact your sleep too, but this could be something to look at. Muscle weakness. So obviously testosterone has a pivotal role in preserving muscle and strength in both men and women, contributes and helps the development and maintenance of muscles and helping you stay strong and resilient. And you may notice a decrease in muscle strength and muscle mass if your testosterone is too low. Weight gain. Testosterone is a fat burning hormone, and it can also affect fat distribution in the body. So low levels can contribute to more fat storing and an increase in body fat, particularly around the middle. Testosterone supports your bones, not just estrogen for your bones, but it helps support the maintenance of strong and healthy bones and can affect your bone density. Heart health plays a role in maintaining healthy blood vessels and promoting cardiovascular function, really vital protection for women post-menopause. Testosterone also influences the growth of your hair, obviously facial and body hair in women. So you may experience changes in hair growth, maybe thinning hair on the scalp or an increase in facial or body hair if your testosterone levels are out. Skin as well, dry skin and a decrease in elasticity can occur with low levels. And lastly, brain health. Now, studies suggest that testosterone may have a really vital role in cognitive function. So you may notice things like difficulty with concentration, focus, memory, or general cognitive abilities. So it's pretty important, this hormone, but it doesn't actually get checked much for women. So there are some ways to increase it naturally. Obviously, exercise is a really good one. All forms of exercise can benefit your testosterone, but particularly resistance and weight training. That's what we want to try and stimulate testosterone and muscle growth and strength. Don't have to go to the gym for that. You can do dynamic yoga, Pilates, and resistance training at home. You get some resistance bands or follow a program online. Really easy to do at home. The other ways to increase testosterone naturally is manage your stress. This comes up every week. We know how damaging cortisol can be generally, and it can stifle your testosterone production as well. Getting better sleep, prioritizing your sleep can also help your levels. Your diet's really important, so eating lots of protein, healthy fats, and good carbohydrates. So this well-balanced plate can have a big impact on your hormone levels. You want lots of nutrient-rich foods in your diets, and you know, really adequate food. So it's shown that severe calorie restriction can lower your testosterone levels. So we don't want to be depriving ourselves, and making sure that we have two really good meals a day if you're doing intermittent fasting. Exposure to chemicals can have an effect as well. We don't want to be getting those xenoestrogens, those foreign estrogens from household chemicals. So choosing BPA-free plastics, going for organic where possible, and using natural skincare and personal and household products where possible. Again, it's just going to minimize that exposure. Vitamin D is important too for testosterone. So getting sunshine on your skin or taking a supplement through the winter months is really, really important. And then some other supplements have been shown to increase or have an impact on testosterone, although, you know, these are going to vary per person. So things like zinc is really important, ashwagandha, and some herbs like saw palmetto and ginger can be helpful. Now, if you have got low testosterone and you are struggling with symptoms, this is when it can get frustrating in terms of, you know, done all the natural things and you're looking for some kind of medical treatment. Because in the UK, the NHS website states that testosterone is not currently licensed to treat symptoms of menopause, but a specialist doctor may be able to prescribe it for you. So we have a very grey area here with testosterone. Some GPs are willing to prescribe it, and that comes in the form of gels or creams. They have to do it off licence. So they have to have quite restrictive cases or reasons to prescribe it. And some of these include surgical menopause, premature ovarian insufficiency, or where you've got low sex drive and nothing else is helping, or where standard HRT hasn't helped your symptoms. So there are some areas, and you know, these are quite key as well, where some GPs are willing to prescribe it, but it's not kind of standard. And a lot of doctors are reluctant to do this because it is off license. But you can be asked to be referred to either a menopause clinic or a specialist doctor if you're not getting anywhere with yours. Why it can't be standard treatment is just a bit baffling to me. It's a sex hormone just like oestrogen and progesterone, and there's no actual evidence that low-level treatment is harmful in any way. So again, it's something that women have been, I think, deprived of for many years and still not getting the support we need in that respect. If you do suspect your testosterone is low and you have some of the symptoms I've mentioned and you've checked your other hormones, I would always recommend you get some tests done first to measure your levels and rule out any of those other hormone imbalances that can cause similar symptoms. So things like thyroid, obviously your estrogen, progesterone, blood sugar, things like that. So we run blood tests for all your sex hormones, but we also run a deeper 24-hour urine test that looks at all your hormone pathways, so we get a really comprehensive pattern of your hormone activity, including testosterone and all its different pathways, which can be very helpful to know whether it is actually low testosterone or whether it's something else that's causing the symptoms. Also, these test results, you know, can be helpful sometimes to take to your doctor as evidence. But there always is, obviously, always the option to get testosterone from a private doctor or a clinic. Unfortunately, that's just the way it is. Remember as well that individual responses to any of these strategies I mentioned can vary, and it's really important you do consult with a healthcare provider before making any significant changes to your exercise or diet or routine or supplements or taking HRT, especially if you have underlying health conditions already. But do contact us if you need any more information on the tests we offer or our one-to-one support. And I hope that's been a helpful summary of testosterone for women. Take care.